Hi, everybody. Bob Sokoler, Sokoler Team Remax Properties East. I'm out getting a little sun, and I think I've overdone it. But this is time for an update for both Louisville and Southern Indiana real estate. Some big news that's breaking around our area. A lot of buyers were fed up, angry, as a matter of fact, with the number of homes on the market, or the lack of homes on the market. And they put offers in, they couldn't get a house. Some people, we heard 20, 30 offers, never got the house because other people were coming in overbidding, paying cash, and a variety of other things. So a lot of buyers went back on the fence saying, okay, I'm gonna wait for things to quiet down and then I'll try buying a house. Well, good news, make note, things have started to quiet down and the home that you may have been interested in may be coming back on the market. Here's the story. Here's what's going on. So we had a number of homes in July, the beginning of June and May, that the asking price, the one price that was on the market when it first went on, was actually the starting price. That was the very base figure that people were paying. They were overbidding by $20,000 and more. And so what ended up happening was a lot of homes sold, but at $20,000, $30,000, $40,000 over list price. Now, what's happened, we've gotten to the appraisal phase on a lot of these. This is after inspections, appraisers go in, and they're saying, no, this home is not worth the amount of money that the offer is that's gonna be paid for by a mortgage company. Now, mind you, if it's a cash offer, not a problem. Don't worry about that. That's going to go through, especially if it's not based on an appraisal. But in many cases, what we're finding is appraisers, and they've got a tough job. We'll talk about that in a second. Appraisers really do control whether a home sells or not. Because if they pull comps and they say, nope, this house may be only worth, say, $200,000, but the offers go up to $240,000, the accepted offer is $240,000, they're going to say, we're not going to loan on that. We're not going to let the bank loan on the house because it's well overpriced. That's what their basic job is. So as a result, in some cases, you'll see that the deal falls apart completely because the seller says, oh, I'm not going to take the deal now because I had $240,000. I'll wait for the next buyer to come along and maybe it'll be cash and maybe the appraiser will let it go for $240,000 if that's what they get. But typically what happens is either the buyer comes up with cash out of their pocket to make up the difference, the seller comes down in price to meet the appraisal price, the two, both buyer and sellers, meet in the middle somewhere or the deal falls apart. So what we're seeing is a number of homes that were sold for a higher price are now coming back on the market. And that is why if you are a buyer who is disappointed because the home you wanted was bought for a lot more money or just went off the market because it was a cash offer, whatever it might have been, you might want to check with your agent to see if by chance they can see if the house has come back on the market, because in some cases they are coming back on the market. So remember that. For sellers, I think it's an important point to remember that even if you get an offer that's well over your list price, it's still not a done deal until the appraiser has gone through and checked to make sure that the house is worth the amount of money that the contract says it's worth. Now, the appraisers are the ones who get beat up here quite a bit, and maybe they're justified for getting beat up, I'm not sure, but here's what I can tell you. They play a very important role in keeping prices down in the Louisville and Southern Indiana area, for better or worse. And when I say that, keeping prices down, let's do a little comparison. You may have heard me talk about this on radio before. And that is, I have a friend who used to work in Boulder, Colorado, and we compared prices of a three-bedroom, one-bath house with a basement or a garage, but not both. And in the Louisville area, yeah, you're probably talking about $150,000 to $175,000 based on the neighborhood. In Boulder, Colorado, where appraisers did not keep a lid on prices, that same house sold for some $650,000 because the price of homes kept going up and up and up and up. And the appraisers let that happen. But in Louisville and Southern Indiana, we typically see 3% appreciation, and that's basically it. no more. But in the past 3 or 4 or 5 months, because of a bidding war, because there weren't very many homes on the market, we saw homes sell at a much higher price. But again, that was before the appraisers had time to look at the comps and say yes or no. Now, in some cases, these things do get through and buyers get their house paying a lot more money for it. But for the most part, appraisers are keeping a check on the price of homes. So if you're a seller, still a really good time to put your house on the market and try to get top value for it. Again, we're still dependent on a private appraisal, but even then, it'll sell quick and for a lot of money. And if you're a buyer, this still is a great time to get into real estate, and we expect homes to continue to appreciate year after year after year after year over the next number of years. If you are a seller, want me to come out, visit the house, I'm ready to help you. Call me at 502-376-5483. If you're a buyer, 10 plus agents ready and willing to help you. All you need to do is call me as well at 502-376-5483. All right, I'm going to get out of the sun. Too much sun, I think. I hope I don't have sun poisoning, right? I'll see you soon, hopefully. I'm Bob Sokoler, Sokoler Team, RE/MAX Properties East.